Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you the new features of the PID simulator. First, we have a toggle to turn on or off the three-dimensional representation. We have the camera shake that moves the camera based on the velocities of the rocket. We have a slow motion, 1 means real time, 10 means 10 times slower. Force reduction that reduces the length of the force arrows. That's useful if they get too big and they hide the rocket, for example. If we set high forces to true, the forces will be high. Let's set it to false to see them. We have three types of camera. First is the camera follow, that is a top view of the rocket. We have a fixed camera, that is from the ground, like you will see your rocket fly. And a follow far, that is basically a two-dimensional camera. Let's test it. We have, for example, only a proportional controller. Let's see what will happen. We see that it's completely unstable. Why? Two reasons. First of all, they aren't stable, and second, we can change the input. For example, let's try with a straight up input. That is the input number 3. Remember that 1 is a step, 2 is a pitch over, and 3 is a stabilization. Let's test it. And we see that it's unstable. We can increase the derivative, for example, or we can set up the slow motion. Let's see what happens. We see that the proportion is overcorrecting for small pitchovers and making the rocket unstable. We can change now the derivative, for example, to 136 and the proportion again to 0.4. You have to tune your own rocket to your own parameter. Let's run the simulation again. We see the small arrows here. But well, now the rocket is completely stable. Now, if for example we change our rocket, we can set the new values of longitude and all that here. Let's, for example, make a stubby rocket dividing by 2 the length, but not the diameter. The 3D representation adapts itself to these new values. You still need to update the coefficients of normal force that open rockets gives you. The center of pressure is already corrected. We have tested the slow motion and the fixed camera. Let's try now the follow camera. It's easier to see what the rocket is doing, but the background is not correctly rendered, so I don't use it really that much. And then follow far, that is again a two-dimensional representation. Well, that's all. As in the previous PID simulator, there is anti-windup and a torque controller already coded in the flight computer. Remember that if you set these ones to true, you have to go to the PID function and copy this, so it creates the same output for the same input. Well, that's all. I hope you like it, and I see you next time.